So here in part three, we're going to be looking at Novacut UI development. So we're going to CD into the checkout Novacut trunk that we made earlier. So to launch Novacut from the source tree, do /novacut-gtk. And we'll go ahead and create a project. Should see our clips from earlier, blah, blah, blah. If one knows the drill, I think. This is the drill, if you're new to the drill. And oops, just turn the volume off. So yeah, there's, you know, Novacut, we are all learning to love. So when you launch Novacut from the source tree, there is some magic in one of our foundational libraries, user WebKit, where we set up a CouchDB handler that points to the UI directory. Inside the source tree. So normally when you launch it from not inside the source tree, and by the way, it basically figures that out by seeing if there's a setup.py file. But so normally the UI files get installed in user share couchdb, I'm trying to remember this path, no, I made it up, apps. So you'll see there's Dmedia, Novacut, user WebKit, also DC3, but it's going away, so ignore that. If you look in Novacut, we'll see it's the same files that are in this local UI directory. So one issue with how we do this is it only works from one source tree at a time. So for example, right now Novacut's sort of grabbed this special handler. And if I then went and ran Dmedia from, like, you know, say I ran Dmedia GTK from the source tree, it would then grab it from it. So only one could be doing it at once, but normally that's not an issue because you kind of have to have the other components installed to do anything with them. Anyway, so the whole reason we did all this is our goal was to get the development experience to a point where it's very much like web development, where you change a file and you hit reload in the browser and that's all you do. So I'm gonna open the text editor, which, by the way, yes, I do use GTK. There's a story behind it. And the story is I used Emacs and I decided I didn't care. So a few quick things you probably wanna change in gedit if you happen to use it. And I think, you know, if you're just starting with this and you don't have an editor preference, I'd recommend starting with gedit because it's installed by default. So I would check all this kind of stuff. This is for our coding style. Just check all the things, basically. For tab width, you want 4, and you want to insert spaces into step tabs. So we're pretty fanatical about following good Python PEP 8 conventions and PEP 257, and we use spaces, 4-space indentation. I think the backup copy is annoying because we're using version control like grownups. That's nice. So yeah, do that. And then I also always turn off the toolbar because I want to see my code and not some crap. Anyway, so now I'm going to show you some of the magic of our UI development process. So there's a lot of files in here. Like, we do a lot of prototypes. And so right now the only editor UI stuff that's actually used are these bucket files, like bucket CSS, bucket JS. Actually, I'll just open all of them. But the reason we do these prototypes is, you know, because we can start with a total blank screen at any point, but still have access to all the infrastructure of the Novacut backend and Dmedia and all that, it's just very cheap to prototype. And, you know, in our experience, it's, or I guess not so much our experience, and wisdom we've read and heard. You know, it's hard to take features away from people. So we try to make sure that before we land a feature in kind of the production UI that everyday people would encounter, that we're pretty sure about it. Anyway, so got a little sidetracked there. So let me think of some interesting thing to change. That would be fun. And so you'll see, you know, this is all just CSS. Let's see, I know there's some. There's the slice, sorry. Don't even know my own stuff. Well, James Rogan wrote a lot of this too. The parts that look really nice, basically, you should assume that James did. And then sometimes I copied. But, blah, blah. Boy, I should have looked at this beforehand. Image selected. Okay, so I'm going to change the font size on this, and I'll make it kind of silly big. So I'm saving that. I'm going to go over here and right-click and hit reload. So I just changed Novacut UI without even, you know, restarting the application. You also can inspect element, and this should look very familiar to anyone who's done web development with a WebKit-based browser. So JavaScript console. I want to clean this up. It's kind of waste too much space, but there's also a shortcut for getting to Futon, the couch to be web UI. And you know, this is pointing to this per user couch to be that was spun up by Dmedia that I mentioned briefly in the last tutorial. So you can do stuff in the UI that's important, like toggle the love orb, which is my favorite thing to do. You should do that immediately when you first open the console, just for fun, because we all love the love orb. I love the love orb. You don't have to, actually, but I do, forever and always. So I mean, you know, this was the way we're building Novacut is weird. I will be the first to admit that, but you know, one of the reasons we felt it was the right approach is, you know, we want to really innovate in the UI, and it's all about having, you know, a very plastic way of working with it, where we can just make crazy changes, you know, and experiment very easily. And then also, I think WebKit's, it's a good set of design idioms, you know, because you'd always end up programming custom widgets for this kind of stuff. And I think using WebKit kind of gives us more restraint, you know, more good creative constraints. I love that concept. Then we would have, you know, say like doing a custom Cairo UI, and it's really proven worthwhile. And then, you know, it's also like, you know, like CSS is full of good design idioms that great designers know how to use. And then people like James Raymond can come and make stuff that, you know, blows your mind. So we're pretty sold on that, and I guess that another thing to point out is, in general, we want to have all of our components network transparent. So the idea is, you can take this UI and run basically the same thing in any modern browser, and run the server components, you know, somewhere else, and have pretty close to the same user experience. You know, latency and a few other things are gonna be a little different, but we wanna be able to get close to that. And so basically how Novacut works is the UI talks to CouchDB, and that's all it does. I mean, you know, modifying documents in CouchDB is the API. There's a few places we cheat right now, and that's gonna go away very shortly. So one of the first things you should spend some time learning about is Couch.js. It's our it's basically a JavaScript port of Microfiber, and Microfiber is a REST adapter for talking to CouchDB. So I'm gonna go ahead and init repo user WebKit. Yes, that's what I want. And then bzr checkout lp colon user WebKit trunk. And the UI really doesn't, you know, interact with CouchDB that much normally. Like, say stuff like this. It uses our couch session, which is very high level. And really what the UI modifies is the CouchDB documents. And then, you know, the extent of its interaction with directly with CouchDB is basically, you know, save this stuff or get me this stuff. And it's all done in a way where we use the CouchDB changes feed to make it network transparent as far as like the collaborative stuff. And at this point, the way we do that's pretty solid. Like, it's actually hard to implement UI functionality that doesn't work collaboratively at this point, at least as far as stuff that, you know, is the state stored in CouchDB documents. But anyway, so I'll in this user WebKit, there is a UI directory just like in Novacut and Dmedia, and you'll see in there there's this Couch.js, and like I said, it's kind of one of the most complicated pieces of JavaScript we have probably, and most foundational. So you'll see it's got the same kind of REST adapter like Microfiber. You've got put, get, post, delete, head. Actually, I don't think I've added head to this yet. We haven't really needed it. One difference is that in JavaScript, there are async and synchronous methods for everything. Sometimes doing it synchronously is just way more convenient, and it's not worth the complexity of not. We don't do that too often. Definitely anything like if you make a request that hits a CouchDB view, you definitely want to use the asynchronous methods. So put is the asynchronous put, and put sync is the synchronous one. So that's something you want to play with. But in terms of kind of the high-level interactions, it's all interacting with this session. And basically, as you change docs, you call session.save, which just marks it as dirty. It doesn't yet send it. I probably should call it something other than save. And then you either call commit or delayed commit when you're done. So part of the idea is if you're doing a change that involves updating multiple docs, we want to condense that into a single request to CouchDB. And the delayed commit is basically was added because of this. So this is really fun, and you will find yourself doing it constantly. Everyone we test with, like, they first sit down and they just do this for like, you know, 10 minutes. And it turns out with the append-only database structure that CouchDB uses, this burns through unbelievable amounts of disk space. Like, I remember when we were demoing at UDS, I guess a little more than 6 months ago, and we were sitting there kind of pissing around with it, and all of a sudden we had like a gig and a half Novacut database. So this just adds a little bit of a delay, so you chunk some of the changes together. But I think the delay is short enough that, you know, the collaboration is still decent. And speaking of which, if you want to play with collaboration, the easiest way to do that is to just fire up Novacut GTK again and go into the same project and look like that, like magic. OK. kind of magic is that? How is that possible? And the thing is, I mean, this seems really fancy and amazing, and it is in a lot of ways, but it's also something that just based on the properties of CouchDB, we kind of almost get for free. So if you're excited about working on this, one place, it's a very rich area for research and experimentation, but you'll see here we have nice transitions that help, you know, guide your eye. We don't here yet because partly it just what's going on is in terms of kind of the DOM state changes is more complicated. But, you know, it's a pretty big problem in terms of how do you make sure you're seeing the same thing and kind of guiding through changes. And one thing about how Novacut works is the UI doesn't yet do nested sequences, but the backend and the schema already do. So if you're working in separate sequences, then, you know, I mean, it's totally independent work that's not going to, you know, you're not stepping on each other's toes. We're pretty sure if you're actually working on the same sequence, the UI should really synchronize all the state. So like, say for example, if you open the Clips browser, I think it should open it over here too. And like I said, this is something we're kind of still experimenting with and thinking about. But the reason for that is, you know, the reason to do real collaboration in terms of like feedback we've gotten, it's all about conversationally walking through the same thing. And so you don't want to have to try to communicate about what thing you're looking at, because, you know, that's the hard thing to do that we want to solve for people. So anyway, that's a lot of interesting stuff. Yeah, I can't think of anything super critical. And we're working on documenting more of this. I mean, you know, like I said, we've had to build a lot of infrastructure to make all this happen, and we're still kind of finding our way, and there's a lot of API breaks, and so we haven't rushed into documenting things that we're changing like weekly still. But that's starting to change, and you know, if you want to get serious about this and you get stuck on anything, definitely just stop by the #Novacut IRC channel on Freenode and talk to us, and we'll help you out. And you know, but look at that, look at how neat that is. Another thing that I, you know, have to be a little proud about, no one else can do this right now. And I don't just mean open source stuff, you know, no proprietary stuff can do real-time collaborative editing. You know, I mean, Novacut's the first, no one beat us to it. And we've done a lot of work laying kind of groundwork for the next set of features, like multicam, especially. And as we kind of get that back and groundwork done, it's going to start getting easier and easier to move faster on the UI and to try, you know, really bold new things. So we think it's going to be a playground for UI designers. So, all right, thanks for watching.